I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Now for the Texas Pledge. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state under God, one and indivisible. Now for the moment of silence.
The best way of spreading Christmas cheer is singing loud for all to hear.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Okay. Welcome back to a Christmas edition of HLTV. I'm Melaine Ojeda.
And I'm Peyton Gwynn.
And welcome to HLTV. Fall midterms are next week. Remember, only seniors can exempt half-credit courses with final exams. Sorry, underclassmen. Students granted a final exam exemption must still attend the class during the final exam period and must be present the entire duration of the class to be considered exempt. Get plenty of rest and good luck on finals. Here's a quick look at the schedule. Tuesday will be 6th and 8th, Wednesday will be 1st and 2nd, Thursday will be 5th and 7th, and Friday will be 3rd and 4th. The Woodlands High School Marching Band recently competed at the Bands of America Grand National Championships from November 10th to November 14th. They performed their show, Life is a Cabaret, against over 100 bands and were awarded fourth place in the nation. This is the first time the band has been in the top five since their win in 2013. Post-marching band, the Woodlands High School Band and Color Guard have separated and have begun to work on their respective winter seasons. Both are already hard at work producing more shows and concerts for everyone to enjoy. Congratulations and good luck, Band and Color Guard.
You're in Color Guard, right?
Yes.
Yeah, good job.
Thank you. The Woodlands High School Color Guard is also currently trying to raise money for the WGI World Championship in Dayton, Ohio in early April of 2022. The nationally ranked World Guard team was scheduled to compete in 2020, but due to COVID, a national championship was not held. Their goal is to raise $20,000, and they are already a third of the way there. This is usually a biannual trip that the Guard seniors miss out on, so let's try and get our Highlanders to Ohio.
This November, Student Council held a food drive for Matthew's birthday wish. They gathered over 8,000 non-perishable foods and raised over $3,000 for this great cause. Student Co. also participated in the Salvation Army Kettle Drive on the 4th. If you would like to volunteer or have any questions about Student Council, be sure to ask Ms. Garter. The theater department had a successful weekend at the Texas Thespian State, where 13 of their students qualified for nationals. Senior Aaron Johanna won first in state for the Musical Works competition for his original musical, Mascot. Sophomores Damian Middleton won best short film in the state with his film, Party Boy. The troupe placed top five in the dramatic scene challenge. They were also able to perform in the world premiere of the play That Goes Wrong on the Texas Thespian main stage and took home 8 awards for their show. The improv troupe dominated, taking home first in state after going head-to-head with the 76 troops from all over Texas. Congratulations, Highlanders.
The Woodlands High School counselors are hard at work scheduling the upcoming Parent Information Night and Elective Fair. The events are to take place Monday, January 24th, and will be held at the senior campus. This will be a great opportunity to explore the various programs the Woodlands High School has to offer. Counselors will present slideshows that will share information about dual credit and AP courses, as well as general high school information. Be sure not to miss it. Christmas is right around the corner, and let's see how our Highlanders are getting into the spirit.
I'm Melaine Ojeda.
And I'm Peyton Gwynn.
And we're going to roam the halls for some Christmas trivia.
Today I'm with
Santiago Padilla,
Alexa Duran,
Camilla Rodriguez.
Darian Garcia.
Aiden.
What are the names of Santa's reindeer?
So we have Dasher, Dancer, Princeton.
Dasher, Prancer, I don't know. Oh, just throw in the Grinch.
Rudolph.
What is the flavor of Pop-Tart that Buddy the Elf puts on his spaghetti?
I don't know, cinnamon? Cranberry?
Cinnamon.
Pop-Tarts don't go on spaghetti.
What's your favorite Christmas tradition?
Honestly, just spending time with family, decorating.
I'm going to Mexico every year to visit family.
Christmas Eve, we all go up to my grandma's house, and that's pretty fun.
Thanks for joining us on this Christmas edition of Highlander Hallways. Make sure to follow us on Instagram at AVTWHS.
And now for some Christmas sports.
What's a Christmas sport?
Forget about it. With the basketball season just starting, the Lady Highlanders have been absolutely crushing it. The freshman team has a 9-2 start to the season thanks to their captains Claudia King and Samantha Simpson. Our team plays third in the Conner ISD JV tournament with Lillian Mitchell killing it with a tenacious defense. The varsity team fended off the Lady Wildcats with a close game of 46-45, stepping into their territory of Humble ISD. The girls took to build their confidence after such a close game. Good luck, Highlanders. On Tuesday, November 30th, the Woodlands High School varsity basketball team, led by head coach Dale Reed, faced off against Seven Lakes. Unfortunately, they lost, but it was a close game, 44-48. Their new record stands at 6-2. In their next game, the varsity will go head-to-head with Memorial High School at 7 p.m. at the large gym Tuesday, December 7th. You can go on their website, www.highlanderbasketball.org, to find the tournament schedules.
Thanks for tuning in to our Christmas edition of HLTV. I'm Peyton Gwynn.
And I'm Milena Ojeda.
And happy holidays, Highlanders.